Also in the South County tonight, air quality will soon be better in Arvin, at least on paper. The Arvin Air Monitoring Station has been moved to a site where the air is cleaner. 23 ABC South County reporter Chris Ornelas is in the newsroom tonight with why some people are so upset by this move. Chris?
Well, people we spoke to say they think that the Air Resources Board is pulling a fast one. They think that they moved the site so they can meet federal requirements for air quality.
This trailer is the air monitoring station for Arvin. For 20 years, it sat on the grounds of the Arvin Edison Water Storage District, but now it's been moved 2 miles away near an elementary.
They were happy to move the monitor, knowing that it would help improve the air.
The station was moved after a dispute between the Air Resources Board and the Water Storage District. The board leased the land from the Water Storage District where the trailer sat. After the dispute, the Water Storage District refused to renew the lease.
Both monitors ran last year. The new monitor had 28 violations. The old one that's been there for 20 years had 68.
Since the new location reads cleaner than the old one, activists say we'll never really know if the air in Arvin is getting cleaner.
It doesn't improve the air in our lungs, but it improves the air on paper.
Experts say moving the monitoring site may get Arvin closer to federal air quality standards sooner than expected.
This allows them to get into compliance with the standard sooner than they would have otherwise.
Environmentalists are upset that 20 years worth of data have become meaningless, but they say it's the people of Arvin who will pay the price.
The children who have asthma in Arvin are suffering probably worse than anybody else.
Now, we called the Air Resources Board for comment, but so far no one has called us back. Now, Fran says the Water Storage District is supported by federal dollars, so he says his group will ask the EPA to force the monitoring station to return to the old site. Fran says before it's all over, this whole thing will likely end up in court. Live in the newsroom, Chris Ornelas, 23 ABC.